Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on Subaru FA20 engine problems and reliability. The Subaru FA20 engine was introduced in 2012 and remained through 2021 in the Subaru WRX. There are two primary variants of the FA20 engine. One of them is known as the FA20D, which is a naturally aspirated variant of the FA20, in which Toyota actually collaborated with Subaru to help design a couple aspects of this engine, notably the fuel injection system, which I point that out specifically since that will come up in one of the problems I discuss for the second variant of the FA20 engine, which is known as the FA20F, or commonly referred to as the FA20DIT or DIT. The FA20F is the turbocharged variant of this engine and was designed only by Subaru, so in this case it uses Subaru's direct injection system rather than the dual port injection like the Toyota system on the FA20D. So anyway, just wanted to point out up front there are two different variants of this engine since that is going to come up while discussing some of the common problems. Now that said, both of these engines do offer a solid overall balance of performance, efficiency, and reliability. However, no engine is perfect, and so both of these engines and variants do have their share of common problems. And that being said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common Subaru FA20 engine problems. Number one on the list, we have carbon buildup. As I mentioned a little bit in the intro with these two variants, the FA20D uses Toyota's fueling system. It's their D4S fueling system, which actually combines both direct and port injection. So carbon buildup is not an issue that affects that engine. Instead, this is unique to the FA20F, the turbocharged engine variant, and that's because this engine only uses direct injection. All engines produce some natural oil blow-by, which makes its way into the intake tract and ultimately sticks to the back of intake valves and on the intake ports. Traditionally, with port injection, you have fuel and all of the detergents spraying into the intake ports. That's why it's known as port injection. And all of those detergents will wipe away any of those deposits. However, with direct injection, you don't have any fuel spraying over those ports or valves, which means that oil can actually start to build up and harden on the back of the intake valves as well as on the sides of the intake ports, and that's ultimately what leads to carbon buildup. With that in mind, if you're looking for a WRX with this FA20 turbocharged variant, it's a good idea to go ahead and walnut blast those intake valves roughly every 80 to 120,000 miles. Now, the good news with carbon buildup, it shouldn't cause any reliability issues in the long term, nor should it reduce the longevity or lifespan of the FA20 DIT engine. However, over time, as carbon builds up on those intake ports and valves, it can start to interrupt airflow into the cylinders, which can result in misfires, inconsistent ignition timing across your cylinders, as well as potentially rough idle and overall just poor performance if the carbon buildup gets serious enough. So again, not a serious issue in the grand scheme, but if you are looking for a WRX for maximum performance, and especially if you're looking to tune and modify the engine, then it's a good idea to go ahead and walnut blast those intake valves, again, roughly every 80 to 120,000 miles. Moving on to our second most common problem, we have valve spring failure. Now, this is mostly unique to the FA20D or the naturally aspirated variant. I don't want to spend too much time talking about valve spring failures on this engine since there's tons of information out there about it. It actually predominantly affected the early 2013 models. However, there still were a significant number of engines recalled from the early days of the FA20, not necessarily something to hold against it since with any new engine design, there are always going to be some kinks to work out. However, in the case of these valve spring failures, it is a very popular and hot topic since there are still some ongoing lawsuits and potential issues surrounding the valve spring failure, and it's really not something I would worry about too much in looking to pick up an FA20D engine. It's mostly just something to be aware of if you are in the market for one of these engines, and something that for the most part has been resolved by now. Moving on to our third and final common problem for the Subaru FA20, we have connecting rod failures. Now, this is something that I really don't feel like is fair to consider a true common problem. However, there really just aren't a ton of issues to discuss specifically with the FA20 engine, so I wanted to throw this in to talk a little bit more about the turbocharged variant and the fact that it is very easy to tune and modify, especially being in the WRX, obviously a great tuner's car, a great performance and sports car. Ultimately, the connecting rods are a known weak point in the engine once you start increasing power and boost. So on stock power levels, I wouldn't worry about connecting rod failure at all. And again, in that sense, I would not consider this a common problem on the FA20. Again, it's just something to consider if you are looking to modify one of the FA20F turbocharged engines. Now, one of the most important points here is the rods are generally safe up to about 350 torque, maybe even a little bit more now that tuners have learned more about this engine. And that's an important number just since it is easy to achieve those numbers on the stock turbocharger just with a tune and some basic bolt-on mods. So a couple considerations here if you're looking to tune and modify this engine. Keep boost under about 21, 22 PSI. Stick with conservative tunes and be careful with the low-end torque on these engines since that can be more devastating and more likely to bend rods, making too much torque and boost very low down in the RPM range. And then lastly, go ahead and work with a reputable quality tuner if you're really planning on pushing those limits and set you up with a safe conservative tune for your specific build. So that's really all there is to connecting rods. Again, not something I would consider an issue at all at stock power levels, just one of those things to keep in mind if you are planning on modifying this engine. Anyway, that really wraps up the most common problems on the FA20D and FA20F engines. So talking a little bit more about overall reliability of these two FA20 engine variants. They're both reliable engines, really not much to discuss when it comes to common problems, hence the reason I spent half this video talking about valve spring failures, which were covered under a recall, as well as connecting rod issues, which aren't a problem on at stock power levels and rather become an issue once you start tuning and modifying the engine too aggressively. Other than that, carbon buildup is really going to be the main problem on the FA20 turbocharged variant. And again, even that isn't that serious of an issue in the grand scheme. Just something to consider if you're looking to get maximum performance out of these engines, you want to go ahead and get those intake valves walnut blasted and cleaned. Keep that airflow nice and smooth and really will go a long way in delivering maximum performance from the engine. A couple final notes here, just things that apply to any car in general. Of course, a lot of this reliability comes down to how well you maintain the car, how you drive and use the vehicle, and then lastly, a little bit of luck of the draw in the mix. Naturally, some engines are just going to be built a little bit better than others, and other engines, even with great maintenance and great care, will still run into more issues than the average FA20 engine, but that's nothing to really specify with the FA20. So ultimately, maintain it well, take good care of the car, and ultimately hope you have a little bit of luck on your side. Assuming all of that works out, it's very likely these FA20 engines will survive to 150 to 200,000 plus miles without having any really serious or significant issues along the way. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.